strange parallel.
Strange parallel.
Strange parallel.
Strange parallel.
Excuse me. Have you seen Elliot Smith?
We've been looking for Elliot Smith on and off, going to different bars. He keeps giving us almost the right address.
Stares into space like a dead China doll. I'm never gonna know you now, but I'm gonna love you anyhow.
So do you have a hard time finding Elliot? Like, you know, getting a hold of him and stuff. He's, like, so vague when he leaves us directions and stuff.
Yes, I do. Everything from a phone to a pager. Even just ask him to get, like, a voicemail system, and I'll leave messages on there.
Now she's done, and they're calling someone. Such a familiar name. I'm so glad that my memory's remote. 'Cause I'm doing just fine, hour to hour, note to note. Here it is, the revenge to the tune. You're no good, you're no good, you're no good, you're no good. Can't you tell that it's well understood?
Elliot came in several times. We became friendly. I didn't know he was writing songs. Very quiet. A real gentleman.
Never gonna know you now, but I'm gonna love you anyhow.
You were saying that here.
It's hard to find Elliot.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, if he's in town, they always call here looking for him. His management company and friends and everybody, and usually it's, he's not here.
It's okay, it's alright, nothing's wrong. Tell Mr. Man with impossible plans to just leave me alone in the place where I no mistakes, in the place where I have what it takes. I'm never gonna know you now, but I'm gonna love you anyhow. I'm never gonna know you now, but I'm gonna love you anyhow.
We finally found Elliot. He was recording in Portland, Oregon, a new song he had floating around in the back of his mind.
Probably Miss Misery by Elliot Smith from the Good Will Hunting soundtrack. It's probably been heard by more people, that's for sure.
I thought it was kind of low in the mix of Good Will Hunting, didn't you?
Do you miss me? Miss me like you say you do.
And of course we know. Was nominated for an Academy Award. What surprised me, I was delighted to hear that Elliot's song, Elliot and his song was nominated.
Men in the park read the lines in my head. Told me I'm strong, hardly ever wrong. I said, men I seen in a magazine.
Later on, we hooked up with Elliot out in New York City. He showed us around his neighborhood and introduced us to a few of his bartenders.
Left lying around.
He was a lovely person. I knew very little about him, but we talked, and he was by himself, and sometimes he did some writing. I did not know what he was writing, not when I first met him.
What is this for? None of your business.
They're making a documentary on me. I play music.
See, I used to come in here as a customer myself. I'm a writer.
You go, boy.
So when I started working here, I met Elliot. There was sort of a strange parallel.
Constant interviews.
Yeah, and it's probably the worst thing that he has to do in his career. Because he could do anything else, but he hates interviews.
Have you been listening to a lot of Beatles lately?
I've been listening to a lot of Beatles since I was like 4 years old. But
what was it like being a musician that sold to a relatively select group of people that the Kill Rockers audience is, and then suddenly being nominated for a Grammy? And playing at the Grammys on national TV.
What was the Oscars?
I suppose.